Hey guys, welcome to today's Vehicle Visionary. Today we're at Mercedes-Benz of Shreveport, right here in the showroom, and this is the 2022 Mercedes-Benz EQS 580, or really more accurately stated, the Mercedes-Benz EQS 580, because Mercedes EQ is the sub-brand that is going to be putting out these EV or electric vehicles. Real quick, we've got a giveaway today, and if you want to be entered to win the sticker, and it doesn't have to be this sticker, I've got others as well that have other Vehicle Visionary logos, all you have to do is leave a comment. So let's talk about exactly what you have here, but first of all, let's talk about something you don't have here. You don't actually have a frunk. So if you were buying one of these, or maybe you were just checking it out and curious about it, you can't actually open this. Obviously they can at the dealership if they need to, but that is not storage space. Although there is ample storage space, we'll talk about that when we get to the rear cargo area. And so as we take a look here at the front end, of course I've got the turn signals on. I'll show you how to turn those on later on in case you don't know, using the turn signal lever in the interior, because a lot of people, at least around Shreveport, Louisiana, well, they don't seem to know how to do that. Always give tutorials. Yes, it's good to laugh when you watch these videos. So, got the turn signal indicators built on or turned on here. Also, the active lighting here with these front headlights. Very, very useful, because obviously they're going to follow the direction you're going on the road. Now, here's something that's interesting. The fact that it looks like you have two Mercedes-Benz logos here on the front end. One here on the hood, basically. One right here. But there's actually two more. I'm going to have Carrie come in and show you one on the right-hand side and one also on the left-hand side. So in case you're curious about some of those sorts of things, now you know. And the kind of faux grille of sorts that you have right here, that is actually based on the new design. We actually featured that on the 2022 CLS 450, but notice how the design right here is different from what we've seen on other real grills in the past, kind of the diamond block, basically. That's what you have here. And of course, this lower area is going to allow air in to help cool the battery, because obviously that puts out a lot of heat. But here's something interesting. Here on the side, you will find vents right here on each side, but it's not really what I would call an air curtain, so to speak, because it doesn't actually go all the way through the side of the fender right here and come out in front of the front tire. That's actually, again, putting air in there to help cool that battery. When you start and stop these vehicles, you're going to hear a lot of fan noise. Not that it's a problem when you're driving down the road, but obviously that stuff's very important. And as we work our way around here to the side, the AMG multi-spoke wheel, 21 inches on this particular model. But something that I really like here is this inner area right here with the black. It'd probably show up a lot better if we were outside in the sunlight. But I think if you don't notice that, it's one thing, but it really sets these wheels off tremendously, just having that design there. Haven't really noticed that on too many other models. Now, one thing that's very interesting here, a lot of people are going to see, is what's right here. It's not what you might think it is if you haven't already seen a video on it. You might think that's the charge port. Well, it's not. That's actually, if you were driving down the road and you got an indication that you needed some new windshield washer fluid, or you were low on windshield washer fluid, that's probably the best way to put it, that's where you would actually fill it. Kind of an interesting little thing, a little tidbit of information. And for those who always ask about it, yes, obviously at $124,000, you will have turn signal indicators built into the side view mirrors. You can see the camera underneath there. There are cameras all over this vehicle. The EQS logo right here. And as I come up, I can just touch the door handle. You can see that you have the illuminated door handle actually right here. Obviously, probably not going to show up as well here in the showroom, but let me open the door. Tell me what you think about this. Everyone probably has their individual opinions, but you have a frameless door window, or frameless window, I should say, right here, so you don't have the actual frame up here. It does give it a little bit more of a clean look. You do have a very nice size armrest, not only up here, but down here as well. Soft materials and quite a bit of nice contrast stitching. But here's something that's interesting. Have to get used to this, but once you do, it's no problem. You have to actually reach all the way right here to find something to grip to close the door when you're sitting inside. I know that from my own experience the first time we hopped into one of these EQS models. Let's take a quick look at the remote. And one thing you might think to yourself that you don't see there is remote start. Well, you do have remote start available. It's not on the remote itself. It's actually going to be on your cell phone when you get the Mercedes Me app. Now, something that's interesting here, before I cover that though, I do want to say one thing. As we take another look here just at the back of the remote, just so you can see the whole thing, here's something that would be interesting. And I realize that obviously the remote would need a stronger battery that would last longer to do this, but tell me what you think about Mercedes possibly adding some ambient lighting to the remote right here. That would be kind of cool. But here's something that you might wonder about. I talked about the area right here where you fill the windshield washer fluid. Does that lock when you lock the vehicle? So let's lock the vehicle and find out. The good news is, yes, it does. So you don't have to worry about somebody coming along, maybe one of those YouTube trolls or correction Nazis who like to cause so much trouble in the comments section, who maybe you find out that you have an EQS and think, I'm gonna get you back now, but you can't do that. So you win. All right, as we start our tour of the rear exterior, I want to point something out interesting about these lights here, the taillights in the rear. They do have an angle, but one thing that's interesting is that they also spiral as they go. So it kind of makes it look like they're almost connected to each other, but it's just a very interesting upscale look, something you would expect. And there is a small spoiler right here. Not too much, not too little. I think that's really kind of the right size for that. Now, let's talk a little bit about cargo space. And here on this particular model, you do have the hands-free lift gate here. You can use the logo right there and push that to open it as well. But if your hands are full, obviously you don't want to do that. And maximum cargo space, 63 cubic feet. That is a lot. So like I said, even though you don't have the use of the frunk up there, you do have 63 cubic feet of cargo space. And then of course you also have the ability to lower these rear seats. I'm not going to do that all the way, but you can fold those down flat on both sides. And just to show a little bit more of what's here, let's look inside this area. You do have the 110 volt emergency charging cable, is what Mercedes calls that, just so you know what's here. Now, one thing, and I know a lot of people are probably going to say this is not their favorite, but it is what it is because of the fact that basically the entire underside of the vehicle is a battery. There's not a spare tire. You do have the tire repair kit, just something to consider. And of course, you have the additional use of the buttons right here for closing this lift gate, or whatever you want to call that, the hatch. On the left-hand side right here, you can just push that and it's going to come down. If you want to push the button on the right, that's going to lock the interior as you close the hatch at the same time. And for where the real charge port is, maybe where you might not expect after what we saw on the left front fender, here is where your charge port is located. So you can plug that cable in that we just looked at right there. You've got the ambient lighting right here. If you want to take advantage of that, that will help you at night. And you've got the QR code right here. And if you're wondering what exactly that is, well, let me show you. We're going to just hold the phone up right here. Let's see if we can get to it. Where are we? There we go. Okay, we notice what pops up right here. So this is what you have when you scan that QR code. Actually, what would happen if there was an accident and occupants were trapped, then the first responders would basically know what's going on within the vehicle, where the charges are for the airbags, and maybe if there's airbags that didn't deploy, well, it helps to keep not only the first responders safe, but anybody who may be trapped in the vehicle as well. Obviously, I hope if you own a model like this, you never need that. And as you hop into the back seat, of course, I'll have Carrie show the door panel over there to his right. You do have a decent sized door bin right there. You can put a bottle in there or whatever, snacks or maybe some beef jerky. If you're bodybuilding and you want to keep your body as lean as possible, keep that body fat down. And of course, you're going to find comfortable seating back here. Let's just show something that is very interesting, though. You've got the fold-down armrest. And if you go to find the cup holders, or your rear seat passengers do, and they just do this right here, it looks like you kind of have a pin holder of sorts. You have to just push it again, kind of like that. That reveals the cup holders right here. Just so you know, I know the first time we did one of these vehicles, we saw that, and it was a little confusing until we figured that out. The pillow headrest, that is nice. I have to admit, I really like that. Very comfortable, very plush, in fact. And I don't know how well Carrie can get the view of the sunroof back here. I don't know if I'd call it so much of a panoramic sunroof because you have the split right here, but you have a rear sunroof for the passengers and then obviously another one in the front that obviously opens for the front seat as well. Now, dual air conditioning vents right here, so you're gonna have the air flowing in the back, but other than that, there's not much back here to report on other than the dual USB ports. You do have map pockets on the rear of the seats, but obviously the main area of activity is going to be in the front, and trust me when I say there is a lot to show. So we're gonna start showing the door panel here on the driver, or the passenger side, I should say, in the front. A larger door bin, you're gonna notice the controls for controlling the seats. You've got heated and ventilated seats, quite a few options there. And if you've never noticed before, I'm gonna show you something you'll never be able to unsee. On the controls right here for changing the position of the seat, if you've never noticed, that actually is in the shape of the seat. So that really makes everything pretty easy to deal with. And so I'm gonna have Carrie hop on in here, and we're going to get started is the hyper screen, or maybe I should say the hyper screens. You know, if you go back to, I believe it was biology where I learned that the word hyper means many, and you do have many screens here. And what's really cool, let's see if Carrie can multitask. I'm gonna let him show you what you can do there on that screen. On the passenger side, you can basically do everything that you can do on the center screen right here. And so there's a lot of features and functionality there. So it's just kind of a mini screen of sorts for what you can do here in the center. So if the passenger wants to make changes or see what's going on or pull up navigation, it's a little slow in here, but there you go, you got it to pull up. You can pretty much see everything that's there. A lot of great features and functionality here. Of course, the same thing here in the center. So I'm gonna just scroll through some of that. You know, it's the same basic stuff. We won't harp on that too much. But the thing I really like here is the ambient lighting. And so let's see if we can get over here to the vehicle, and we will go to light. Let's see if we can get there. We're gonna go to ambient lighting. And one thing I like about this is the fact that the blues seem to show up the best. So let's change a little bit, make sure we've got our brightness set as high as possible. We're gonna go to color, and we'll just do the blue right here. Let's just see, there we go. We've got that to show up a lot better. You can see that it is everywhere. If we were in a darker area, I think it would obviously show up better, but that still looks really impressive. And you can have, it does have active ambient lighting, so it can change colors as you're driving down the road, and it just changes throughout the whole vehicle. Very interesting. You also have 64 different colors. If you're wondering what all is right here, that is 64 different colors. And we'll just change it one time there. That's still pretty easy to see, a lighter blue, but obviously a lot of great features there. And one thing I'm gonna do, the cool thing about being here in the showroom at the dealership with this particular vehicle is the fact that I can actually start the vehicle. You can hear some of those noises I was talking about. Hear that? I told you there's a lot of noises that this car makes. I'm gonna go into reverse right here. Hear that sound? It's letting people know that I am in reverse. And so that's really a nice feature, and so many different angles right here that you can look at. You will never have any trouble wondering, oh, am I gonna hit something that's around me in a tight area? See if we can do that. I'm not used to this, so just keep in mind, that's what's going on there. It's not because it's slow to respond. It's because Tom is not doing a good job. So we'll go back here real quick. Okay, there we go. Just giving another view. That's the front view right there. So you have the front view camera. And hopefully Carrie can get a good shot of the steering wheel here. You've got the steering wheel mounted controls. By the way, that is a different design from what we've seen on some of the S-classes of the past, obviously. I like it, but it's taken a little bit of getting used to, but obviously you can still do the same things of controlling the functionality of the middle screen from the right-hand side. And of course, the dashboard here on the left-hand side. And speaking of the dashboard, I love what Mercedes-Benz has done with this dashboard. It is so impressive, and obviously you can customize that. But one thing that I do want to show here, just in case you've never had a vehicle that has this option before, this lever over here on the left-hand side of the steering wheel, watch what happens on the dashboard when I push it into the up position. You see that arrow flashing to the right? And when I push it into the down position, that arrow changes to flashing to the left. Well, that corresponds with the blinkers on the vehicle. So that means you can let people know what you're doing when you're driving down the road, whether you're changing lanes in front of them or turning to the left or turning to the right. I know it's a very novel idea to let people know what's going on with you. And of course, let's not forget that you have your helper here, Mercedes. Let's do something. Hey, Mercedes. Let's try that one more time. Hey, Mercedes. Hey, Mercedes.
How can I help?
Change the ambient lighting color to green.
Okay, I'm changing the color.
And that's just one of many different things you can request that Mercedes does for you. She's always going to help you out, basically. If you wanted to know how much charge you have in the vehicle, she'll let you know about that. And by the way, if you're wondering, how far can you drive this model?
To use online functions of the voice system, please check your Mercedes Me settings.
Hey, Mercedes.
She's helping too much.
How can I help?
Be quiet. I guess she didn't like that, so she didn't have anything to say in return. I could ask her what's wrong, and she'd probably say, nothing, I'm fine. Anyway, before I was rudely interrupted there, how far can you drive on one full charge? The EPA, without me getting tongue twisted, the EPA estimation is 350 miles. And you might think, well, I'd like more than that. Well, there obviously is more. I couldn't tell you how much more, but there's always going to be more than what is estimated. So you can guarantee if you need to, I bet you can go more than 360, maybe 370 miles or so. All right, let's talk a little bit about horsepower numbers real quick. 516 horsepower, 631 pound-feet of torque. And obviously, it's going to be a single-speed transmission. That's one reason why these cars are so quick to accelerate. If you've ever wondered the Teslas and other EVs out there, why are they so quick? It's because they don't have to change gears. So that makes a big difference. And as we look here at the center console, you're going to notice you've got your connectivity right there. You've also got the wireless charging pad, which honestly, I would like to see that right here. I'm not going to say that's a bad thing necessarily, but you do have to reach way up in here to put your phone into the wireless charging pad. But the one big advantage of that, with that 631 pound-feet of torque, that charging pad will hold your phone in place, so it's not going to be moving around a lot. I've driven vehicles that were EVs, and when you stepped on the electric pedal, the phone would move. And if you didn't have your sound turned off, you'd hear it connecting and reconnecting and doing all that kind of stuff. But you do have your cup holders right here. And of course, you've got all the functionality for the vehicle right here, including your button to fire things up. I don't know if I'd say start the engine, even though technically I guess that is what you're doing. It's just not like the conventional engine. And the bomb bay doors right here, those opening up somewhat slowly, couple more USB ports right there, and a decent amount of space. Let's see how far down in there I can reach to kind of show you how far that is. It probably is not as easy to see that on the screen as it is in person. And if you're looking for additional storage, it's right here. You actually have a nice storage bin that has a lot of options and potentials. Depending on what you want to do, you ladies can put your purses in there or whatever you might want to. And let's talk a little bit about one thing that you might have thought I left out, MPGs. So here are the numbers on that. 91 estimated city, 98 highway, 94 combined, and 36 kilowatt hours per every 100 miles you drive. All right. So how fast is this thing to accelerate? 3.7 seconds, 0 to 60, but let's just see how it does. I gauge it by Carrie's reaction. Okay, we're going to hop out on the road here for a quick test drive and just have a little bit of fun. Now, one of the things that's really nice here, nothing unusual for the Mercedes brand, is obviously you can set different characteristics of the vehicle, steering, suspension, how the vehicle accelerates, all of that to your ultimate liking. So if you want to drive in sport in one area but comfort in another, well, you can do that. So that's one of the benefits of Dynamic Select. Obviously, with your leather-wrapped steering wheel right here, nice and comfortable. I like to set everything to sport. But the thing I've noticed here, the handling is really good. And of course, with the adaptive suspension, well, I don't probably have to tell you that the ride quality is great. Very smooth, soaking up the bumps very well. Hopefully you can see everything here with the dashboard and the multiple screens that we have here. Everything just flows so well. You feel like you're even further into the future, but obviously 2021/2022, well, you're going to expect to see some very high-end vehicles with a lot of great technology. And that is the thing about this EQS 580, is that it has the latest and the greatest from Mercedes-Benz. And so, no matter what you do, when you're driving down the road, you've got all the safety aids, the driving aids to help out. You've got Mercedes here to help you out. I better not set too loud or she might respond when I don't want her to. Now, as we're cruising through here, I'm not going all that terribly fast, but we'll just have a little bit of a cornering test here. The body roll isn't too bad. I can tell that if we went through corners at a little bit higher speed, you would get some body roll, but this isn't really meant to be a high performance vehicle. So yeah, that's to be expected, but that's okay because, well, it is what it is. Although I do hope that eventually Mercedes-Benz of Shreveport will receive an AMG version for us to try out. So what is my ultimate verdict here? This is a fun vehicle to drive. It has great technology that is not hard to learn and use. So if you're somebody who maybe has never had a vehicle like this before and you're thinking, wow, that's a lot to step into because I've never had that kind of technology, don't worry about it. It's not hard to use. In fact, one thing we didn't show that is within the infotainment screen here, you have the owner's manual and it has animated tutorials to show you how to use pretty much every facet of your vehicle. So there's big benefit in that area. So that's a quick tour of the 2022 Mercedes-Benz EQS 580. And there are a lot of different options you can add that are not necessarily on this vehicle. It's not that it goes up in trim level. This is the highest end, basically. You will have, of course, the AMG model, but it's just gonna be more power, more torque, basically what you have here. So if you're wondering, how much more can I add? Well, quite a bit. We'll feature that as it becomes available. And of course, there is a Maybach version. We'll see if somebody orders one for us to show here at the dealership, or if maybe you own that vehicle or another that you would like to have me feature on the Vehicle Visionary YouTube channel, send me an email. I'll leave my email address down in the contact area or down in the description of the video, and we'll see what we can set up. Gotta say a special thanks to my friends here at Mercedes-Benz of Shreveport for loaning me this model for the day, Carrie for helping out on the camera, and all of you for giving me the opportunity to give you a vision for your next vehicle. If you enjoyed today's video, check out this area of the screen over here. You'll see a couple more videos you can watch, and I'll see you there.